Our today's session is deploying Ansible. In this, we have started this how to work with Ansible configuration file. So first, just recall this session. Then I will start the next particular topic, that is ad hoc command. So what is the meaning of Ansible configuration file? All the parameters that are to be set in this particular configuration file. So the configuration file location can be a global. It means it can be located in etc, and it can also be located in home directory, and it can also be located in which particular? It can be in working directory. So we can place this in any location that I want. So it can be a global, it can be in a home directory, or it can be in your present working directory. So the file name is ansible.cfg, file name is ansible.cfg. If we want do not want any types of settings, you can also copy this particular configuration file in your home directory also, in your working directory also. If you do not define the all parameters, if you don't know what are the parameters, all the parameters that are defined in this particular file, just uncomment these parameters and use them. If you have the knowledge, then you can manually define also. So create this particular file. So what are the parameters that we can set? If we want to create the environmental variable for the configuration file, we can also create this environmental variable. So this will take the first preference. So what is the first preference? In a working directory, it will take first preference. Second preference goes to this particular hidden directory. And the third preference for this one, that I have already told you in the last session. So this has been completed. Just for the recall session, I will tell you. And this is the command to check which configuration file that you are using in your environment. You can use this particular command, and you can also use this particular command. So what are the parameters that I have told you? These parameters that I have told you in the last session. So that is default parameter and privilege escalation. So in this, we have defined the direct inventory location also. And the last one, we have defined this particular true parameters. Then some parameters are rest. See this parameter and this particular parameter that I told you in this session. So see here, I am in this particular. So goes to this particular folder / Ansible. In this folder, we have my inventory file also. So this is the inventory file. We have three machine. So this is my managed host one machine. This is my managed host two machine, three machine. We have three managed host machine. The IP for that one is 110 and 120. So we have three machines in my network that are connected through the control node. So we have total four machines, 1, 2, 3, and 4. One is control node and three managed host machine. So what is the configuration in my configuration file? So see, we have only two parameters that I have set in my Ansible configuration file. What are the meaning of the other parameter that I will told you? Suppose Rahul, tell me, if you want to check the connectivity to the other machine, which particular command you can use? Which command is used to check the connectivity to other machine? Ping. Which protocol work in ping command? Which protocol work in ping command? Protocol. Okay, the protocol is ICMP, Internet Control Message Protocol. This is a protocol that work with ICMP. But so if I want to check the connectivity to these machines, this is my machine also, managed host machine. What is the IP of this one? I will show you. Grab iNet. So this is the IP of this particular machine. And what is the IP of this particular machine? Check See, this is the IP of this particular machine. So we have three machines in my network, and the IPs for these particular machines that are, so check this one also. Hundred, 100, 110, and 120. These are my managed host machine. Suppose I want to check the connectivity to these three machines. So check. This is my one machine. So just remove this hash sign from. Now I am able to connect. See. Hyphen C number of packet, I want to send only just one. I have transmitted one packet, receive one packet. And check the connectivity to this particular machine, that is 110. Now connected, and check the last one. Now I'm also connected. Now, if you want to take the SSH of any machine, which command you can use? So that is SSH. This command is used. So suppose if you want to do SSH to another machine, so what is the meaning of this one? If I want to take the SSH to another machine, so we should have to require one account. So by using that particular account, we can log in on that particular machine, and we also require the password. So I will show you the meaning of that particular parameters. See, so we have a user on this particular machine. We have a user C. We have a lot of users in this machine. So we have one user that is admin. See this one? This is my admin user. Or I will create another one also. So we have admin user here. So see, so just type admin here, and which particular machine? 192.168.10. That is 110, this particular machine. So when we take SSH of this particular machine, so this will take the, match the fingerprint and will send the public key to the non-host file. So I will check the fingerprint also. See, permanently added to which particular file? Non-host file. So this key will be added, public key will be added on this particular file. Now give the password. So what step I have followed? So we have provided a username also, and we have provided the password also. Suppose if NC will take the remote session, so we should have to provide the username here. On goes to this machine, use this particular username and provide the password. You can provide the password also. So just type here true if you want to provide the password. If you do not want to provide the password, so just type false. If we use false, then key pair, or we can say that passwordless authentication will required. But at this time, for accessing this particular machine, we should have to require a password. If we don't have password, I'm not able to take the SSH. But in Ansible, which command is used to check I'm able to take the SSH or not? So we have a command, Ansible command. So this is the Ansible command. Ansible for which particular machine? 192.168.10.110. Hyphen M module. Module name is ping. So I want to check I am able to take the SSH or not. So this is not to check the connectivity. This is used to take the SSH. So this is the name of the module. This module just work like if I am able to take SSH or not. So this will provide the information. If I am able to take the SSH, then this will provide the message ping pong. So ping pong means just for the SSH information, not for like ping command. It's not just like ping command, it's a module. So see here, see what is the message? So at this time, I'm not able to take the SSH. So Rahul, tell me the reason of this. I'm not able to take the SSH. What is the reason of this?
Reason because, sir, you did not enter the password.
Yes, you got my point. So we require two things. The first one is username. The second one is password. You should have two things. The username and password will be required. But I have typed no username and I have typed no password also. So, so hyphen U, it means user. Username is admin. And hyphen K, so it will ask.
Hello, sir.
Hello.
Hello.
Now I am audible yes, for you.
Yes, yes, sir. You are audible.
So there is
I want to know that while you are putting this user is admin. And
yes.
Where from you
so
get the
Ansible? How Ansible will recognize what is your username? Because this command is used to check the SSH. So now see here. Shared connection sudo password is required for this. So this will show me the sudo password. So just if I want to take the SSH, just check the connectivity by using this one. So I will show one more thing also.
K is for hyphen K is used for
what is the meaning? Become means true. It means it will ask for the sudo password. See here. See this one. Sudo password is required because I have typed here just true. So go to this particular configuration file, just vim here and just write false. False. Then check again. So I will show all the meaning of this particular. Now, check again. Now see, permission denied. Because by using this particular, we are not able to go in this location. So now, what is? Cat again ansible.cfg. So we have this inventory file. Just privilege escalation false. So, if I want to check the connectivity to any machine, just if I type here just like this, I am not able to connect because this will take the SSH by using which particular account. See this one. It will automatically take which DevOps. It will automatically take which one? Only just DevOps. What I am not, I do not want to take the SSH by using the DevOps user. I want to take the SSH by a different one user. So see, so I will type here just U. U means remote user. What is the meaning of U? What is your remote user? My remote user is admin. What is my remote user? The remote user is admin. And I want to take the SSH by using the admin. And hyphen K, K means SSH password. It will ask for the SSH password. So see, now check. So this is the password of which user? Admin. I have typed the password manually. I have typed the password manually for which user? Admin user. So this is my machine. For this machine, I am able to take the SSH. Suppose if I erase this whole thing, then see the result. So it will automatically take which user? Local username. Have you understand my point? What? Suppose if you want to take the SSH, I will show you, because you should have the knowledge what Ansible will do. We have two machine and you are sitting here and you have a username here DevOps. Here you have a username DevOps and here you have a username that is admin. And you want to take the SSH, then what you will do? Just type command, this one, and what is the syntax? Just provide the username. Username here, at the rate, then name of the PC or name of IP of the PC. Then this is the whole syntax. So I have typed, at this time I am in a DevOps user. So I want to take, I am able to do SSH. So just, this is the Linux command, SSH. This is my username, admin, at the rate, and this is my password. Sorry, this is my IP address, 192.168.10.110. If I have entered, it will ask for which one? Password. So it will ask for the password. So just provide the password of admin user. So we have no need two things. The first one, remote user. So what is admin? Admin is a remote user. Ask for password. So these two things will be required, that you can enter this in your configuration file. So Ansible can recognize for which particular remote user you want to take the SSH. So I will take the SSH for the remote machine, then I can perform the task. So these username and password will be required. So now you have understand this. It can be anything that you have. Suppose if you have create a user here, see here, this is my machine. In this we have a user, username is this one. And what is the password? That I know. Suppose.
Sir, I am asking that the admin you have applied, the admin username, the password, which will be the password? The system password of the admin or?
Account password, not system. It's a password of admin account.
Admin account password will be applied, no?
Yes, for SSH, what I will do? If you want to take the SSH, what you will do required?
Access of
you admin. Have required just a username and password of that particular account.
That is the symbol.
Not system password. System password means system password. There is no system password. Password is only for the account. The account can be a root. The account can be a regular user. Only these two accounts can be used in your system. There is no system password, because I don't require the service password, because service account cannot be login in my system. So only we have three types of account: root, regular account, and service account.
Okay, sir.
So for SSH, for local login, for remote login, we have required an account. And for that particular account, we have the password of that particular specific account, that by which we want to take the SSH. So this is the full concept that we should know. So we have a account here and for this particular account I want to take the SSH for this particular machine. So we have required the password for this particular account. So from here I am from which particular account? DevOps. And I want to do SSH. Then what will happen? See here, see this result. I have this machine. See what is unreachable. Status false. Message failed to connect the host by. So this will take the SSH in the background. This is a ping module. Modules are just a group of code, group of scripting that will run in the background, that will run in your background. So it will automatically perform this SSH function. You don't need to write this particular Linux command. You just write this particular command. It will use automatically this particular command. I am not using this command because this is written in this particular module. So this is a name of my module that will take the SSH. But see, which username it will take automatically? I am not defining any, that is not defined my this particular file. See here, there is no parameter defined regarding this one. So it will automatically take the local user account. It think there is a DevOps user on the remote machine, but in this particular remote machine we have no DevOps user. If we have DevOps user, then we should only provide the password. If we have the DevOps user on remote machine, that we need only the password for that particular account, then we are able to take the SSH. So this is the full concept. Suppose if I create, see here one more concept. If I create a user, see, if I create a user, user add, then DevOps, same user, and provide the password for that one. See, provide the password. Password. So that is any password. And now you want to take the SSH for which particular machine? For this one. So see, there is a user. Username is DevOps in this machine. So what is the IP of this particular IP? So this is the IP, that is 110. Now check again this particular command. But see, same thing will happen. But if I provide the password hyphen K, this password is not my own machine password. This is the password of which particular machine? This machine for which particular account? DevOps user that I have recently created here, this account. Now we have the account on remote machine and we have also the password. So we should have typed the password of this particular account. Now check, provide password. Now see, I think your doubt has been cleared.
Yes, sir, doubt has been cleared, sir. And by on it only works in DevOps. We can't use, if we provide
admin. If you want to provide different account for this particular, then you should have write in the configuration file which particular account you want to use in the remote user. So what is the remote user that you want to assign for the Ansible? So you should have to put all the settings in which particular file? Ansible.cfg file. At this time I am typing here in which location? In my command line. But we don't want this in this. So this is the meaning of ask password, and it will automatically take this because this is my local account. So this will take automatically. What I do, I want different user account. This one, admin. See, successfully. But how you can recognize? Just type here a argument and argument which argument you want, I want type just ID and just use different modulum command. The check, I have take the SSH by which particular account? See this one, goes to this machine, take SSH by using this particular account and show me what is my ID name. If I type here ID, then what will, if I type ID command, this is the ID command, same, what will it will show? User ID, group ID, this particular, so it will show I have login on this particular account and it will show the ID of this particular account. See this one, this is the 100 group ID, it this is a part of field group also, and this one. So this is the meaning. Suppose if I am not using just here like this one, now check, if I am not using this one, which particular username it will show me? See this one, it will take automatically which user account, this particular account, and this account also exists on which particular machine? This machine. Now you have better, yes, understand this particular thing. It's what clear, I want sir. To say you.
Yes sir, yes sir, it's clear now.
So this is the command. Suppose if you type here which command, if you just type here ID command, what will happen? It will show you at this time you are logging on this particular machine, which particular account? Root account. Suppose if I just type here su hyphen popert, now check again which particular account. If I just want to check ID of admin account, now this is the ID of admin account. If I just type here sudo hyphen I, then but this user is not a part of have no permission of sudo, so this cannot be happen, so I will quit this. So now back, move to this one. So this is the concept. So if I do not want to write this whole thing in my command line, so I can write this whole thing in which one? In my Ansible configuration file. So I put this whole thing my configuration file. So goes to this particular configuration file and see. So just write here the remote user, just remote underscore user. What is your remote user? I will take the session by using the DevOps user in all machine, in this machine also, this machine also, all the machine. I want to take the SSH by using DevOps user and ask underscore pass. I have no keyless key-based authentication, not keyless. I have no key-based authentication. So I want to provide the password for DevOps account. So just type here true. Then check the meaning, what will happen. Now you don't need to provide this whole. And I want to check which account is used to take the SSH. Now check the ID. We have right here the password, but I type just enter. So it will show me just unreachable. Now type the password properly. So I have typed the password. Now check. But I want the keyless, key-based authentication. At this time, this is a password-based authentication. So we have required the password. So I have typed here just ask password true. But see this, it's a false, because in this particular it uses key-based authentication. So what I will do for the key-based authentication, Rahul, tell me. if I want to do SSH by using the key based authentication, so we should have to create a key pair. Which one? That is key pair. This one, private key and public key. So we should have to create a key pair, that is private key and public key. For this account also, I have a DevOps user in this machine or not? /etc/passwd. See, at this time in this machine we have no account. Suppose if I just type, see, in the place of this I want to type just all. What is the meaning of all? Rahul, tell me, what is the meaning of all? It's a predefined group and I want to take the SSH of all machine, my this machine and this machine. Then what will happen? See this one. This bill goes to this machine, but in this machine there is no DevOps user. But in this machine we have created a DevOps user. In this we also have the DevOps user, but in this machine there is no DevOps user. So it will show me the message. See, password instead of key, this one, no. So RC code, that is zero. RC code zero. Zero, zero means successfully. One means not successfully. So in this machine, which machine? 120. So that is 120 machine. See, what is the IP of this one? That is 120. In this machine, at this time, we have no DevOps user. See, /etc/passwd, just grab DevOps. See, we have no user. If I will create a DevOps user also here, so just create a user. Username is DevOps. Just provide the password. I will provide a password, that is Red Hat. And for which particular account? Passwd, that is DevOps user --stdin. Input now successfully. Now I will do this again. Now check, provide the password, but I will take a SSH session first manually. SSH DevOps @ this account. So it will ask for this particular. If I want to disable this thing, we can also disable thing. So this will not ask for the non-host key. So just type first time yes here, then Red Hat again. Now we are able to take the SSH. Now just type this thing again. Then just type. Now we are able to take the SSH of whole machine, all the machines, because all the entries are written in this particular configuration file. So we don't need to provide the user information, and we have type here just true, just provide the password. If I just provide here vim ansible.cfg, is just I type here false, then what will happen? See the result. I am not able to take the SSH. Okay, I am able to take the SSH. What we have no, so I will check first cd.ssh. We have a key. What is the meaning of false? I will show you. If I have no password less authentication, then we can type false. Ask password means when we take SSH, it will always ask for the password. It will take the password. We want to type the password again and again when we take the SSH. But for when we type here false, it means if we have the key based authentication, then we can use false. But at this time, I want to check I have the key based authentication or not. So see here, we have a user DevOps. In this ls-la, we have no key on this machine. CD ls-la, we have a key in this. So go to this machine. This is my private and public key. So at this time in my DevOps, we have the key pair. Check. This is my key pair. This is my key pair. And I have sent this particular key. See, cd.ssh. See here. We have the authorized key. Check which particular account. So now, see this one. This is my control node machine. So I am able to take. If I just see here, remove this one, see again, Vim, if I remove this, and in this machine, I am not, su-devops, just provide the password. ls-la, we have no SSS and we have no SSS folder. ls-la. Now I will check to take the SSH again. Now check. Okay. CD Ansible. Go to this location. Now check what are the configuration we have in this. So I have provided just the username, ask password, false. It will not ask for the password. So that I have defined false here. And become user, that is also false. And now check this particular command. See the result. Because if I want to take the SSH for all the managed host machine, so what we have required? So we can use two things. The first one is password based authentication. We have two types of things that I have discussed in RACSA course. If you have remember in SA1 book, I have told you in a this. So we have two types of SSH authentication. It can be a password based authentication and it can be a password less authentication. It means key based authentication. So we have the key.
So sir,
that is a RSA key. So if we have the RSA key, it means key pair. In a private key, we have the password. If I type the password in private key, so it will not ask for the password. And what is the public key? So this is my public key. So we should have required for SSH public key authentication and password also. So for password based, also required the public key and also required the password. So if I want to take the SSH, then what we have required? See this one. It will take the SSH by using DevOps user. But I am not typing the password because I have typed here false. But we have, at this time, there is no key based authentication. See here. There is no SSH folder. See here, there is no SSH folder. We have here SSH folder. but we have no public key because we have deleted this public key. Because how it can understand which particular user is able to take the SSH of my machine? Only this particular machine able to take the SSH of this particular managed host one machine. So you should have to define this in authorized underscore key particular file, because I have removed this particular. So see here, so this is the result. If I just type here, see again, if I just type here a password, then check, I have defined my this particular file, but in this we have typed the password, then we are able to take the SSH. Because for the SSH, two things will be required: username and password. So we have completed these two things, then we are able to take the SSH. And we want to check the ID, and I want to provide the command. So command is ID command that will show you this is my DevOps user, and I'm able to take the SSH. So this is the concept. So now you have understand this better. What I want to say, Rahul. Now it's clear. Yes, for SSH, two things will be required. It means that is called credential. The first thing, the account information. The second thing, password. So I have given you a lot of example for this particular better understanding. Only these two things I have clear by using these all examples, because this come again and again all the, so you should have to clear what is the meaning of this one, and then I will told about this one. So now it's clear. Okay, then I will move to the next one concept. So see, it's all clear. So this is my command module. This is the module name. M means name of the module. A means I want to perform this particular ID command on which particular machine? All machines. So I will perform this command in every machine. So I can check by using which particular user we take the SSH. See, this is my group ID, this is my user ID, this is my user ID. If I want to define the different username on different machines, we can also define this one, but that I will tell later, not on this particular. So I want to confirm what is the meaning of this particular configuration file and what is the advantage to use this one. So if I am using the key based authentication, so we can type here false. But if I just remove this one, then I am not able to take SSH. But I want to take the SSH without the password. Then what I will do? I will use just SSH hyphen copy ID and go to this machine, DevOps machine, DevOps. At the rate, and that is my managed host one, managed managed host one. So I want to send this particular machine, then provide the password. So this key has been sent. Now check. Now you have the SSH key. Now check this machine. What is the IPA? What is the IP of this one? 110. So just type here 192.168.10.110. Provide password again. Now check again on this machine. ls-la. Now SSH folder will be created. cd.ssh. Now check. We have the authorized key. Now I am have the information which particular account can take the SSH of my machine. Only this particular account can take the SSH of my machine. Now in this we have no SSS folder again here. So just sent ls-la again type. There's no SSS folder. Then do the last thing that is regarding to 120. That is 120. Now give the password again. Now this has been sent. Now check ls-la. Now see cd.ssh. We have the key here. Now check which particular machine? This particular machine. Why which particular account? This account on this machine. This machine can take the SSH of this machine. Now run this command again. Now we are able to do SSH without the password. So this is the concept of ask pass false. So see get ansible.cfg ask pass fault. So we don't require the password because we have the key based authentication. So this is the meaning. Suppose if you want to perform a task, suppose if you want to create a user in this, so just type name of the your user. I want to create a user. The username is Rahul. But by using the Ansible, you want to create the user. The state is present. And the module name, that should be changed. So we have a user module name. So goes all machine, go to all machine, use this particular module. So module is a, it's a predefined codes, predefined scripting in this particular module. A, what type of command you want to run? Just create a user on all the machines. Now check, if you want to check cat slash etc pass wd, just grab here username is Rahul. See, at this time we have no user regarding the Rahul, and I want to create this. Then see the result. We have successfully created the user. The username is Rahul, but that is already created. So just change this one, Rahul CRW crow. Now see this one again. So I am not able to, at this time I am not able to perform this particular command. Why? Tell me Rahul, why I am not able to create the user? What is the reason? Rahul, tell me. If I type this particular command, because I am to do take the SSH also, but I am not able to perform the command. What is the reason of this?
Because sir, DevOps has no rights to give the user.
Yes, you have at this time no permission. Because see here, I will show this. So this is my which user account. Suppose if I create a locally, I am do this work locally. I'm creating a this user that is already exist 1 2, already exist 1 2 3. See, then what you will do? Because this is a regular account, if you want this user will create a user, so you should have to provide the permission, sudo permission. Then you are able to perform this particular command. If I write here just sudo in front of this command, then this user can run this particular command by using the sudo. It's right or not?
No, sir.
So if you have the sudo permission, so I want to check this user have the sudo permission or not. If this account have the sudo permission, then this particular user able to perform all the administrative command. So we should have to provide the remote user as an administrative permission. So we can perform all the commands by using the sudo. See here, which command? Sudo command. So this user can perform the this particular command by using the sudo. So see, it will ask for which particular password? Sudo password. When we type this particular command, it will ask for sudo password. Then check. I have typed the sudo password, but at this time I am not able to perform this particular command because give me 1 minute, just 1 minute. The recording and see the result. I am not able to perform this particular administrative command because this is an administrative command and this is my regular account. So we should have to provide the permission, and for providing the permission we have two things: add this particular user in a Wheels group also, and you can also add this particular user account in which particular file? Sudoers file. If I add this particular account, DevOps account, in which file? Sudoers file. Then we are able to perform the sudo command. So first we should have to provide this one. So move to root account and just type here vim/etc goes to sudoers file. Sudoers file, in this file. So just go to line number 100 and just copy this whole line, this one line, yy, and paste here this one. Just paste this below the root and just type here your username. What is your username? DevOps. And what is the meaning of this one? So the meaning of this one, so we don't need to type the password, sudo password, again and again. So without the sudo password, we want the communication. So we don't need to type the password again and again for the sudo. So DevOps user, this is all no passwd. So copy this whole line, this one, save this one. Then go to this machine again and enable this thing also. See, at this time we have a user and we want to perform this particular command, user add command, and got got. I want to create a user. See this one, what it will ask? It will ask for the sudo password, because in this is a normal account and we have the type the password. But at this time there is no entry of this particular user account in which particular file? Sudoers file. So just go, but by using the root account, root. So just vim here /etc sudoers. Just move to 100, line number 100, and just type, paste here that I have. So see, this is my DevOps user, all and all no passwd. So we have provided the sudo permission, so this user can perform. But in this we have already done this particular thing. See, vim, go to this account su-root, go to through the root account, check in this we have the entry of sudoers file or not. Just check cat not by using the vim/etc sudoers. See, yes, we have the entry. Record, this user is not added here, but it's a part of, just type here id DevOps. This user is a part of wheel group, and for the wheel group we have provided the permission. See, wheel group is also administrative group. You can also enable this particular line. So we have enabled this particular line. So this user also have the sudoers permission. So this is the concept. Now try again for the whole one. Now try. Now we are able to for okay. Rahul CRAW Craw. So change the okay. So if I want for the sudo, I have completed all the things in that one, but I want hyphen b. B means become hyphen b's. B means become as a, so perform this particular command. So we should have to define this particular syntax. What is the meaning of this one? Become a, use sudo command and become as a root. Now check again. Only we have typed this particular option because at this time we have no entry in my configuration file. So I will type this in my command line. Now check. This user has been created because now this time this user has been created by the sudo command and it will take the root session automatically and perform that particular command. Because I have disabled this particular, it I have enabled for not required for the sudo password. Again and again, if I want to create another user, the username is this one. Now we are able to perform the command perfectly. But I do not want this in the command line. I want this whole thing in my configuration file. Then, so we should have to write this whole thing in my configuration file. So use here just, if I just use here, which one? True. And become method, become method underscore method. Which particular method? Use sudo command for perform any administrative task. Any administrative task. Become method, it's a sudo. Become user, become underscore user. So perform the command by using the root account. And become ask underscore pass. I have type here true. If you type here true, so it will always ask for the sudo password again and again. So I have type here false. Now check again the whole thing. So I will not type this particular, then create a different user. This user. So this will create a user. So now I am able to perform this particular command. And if you want to check what happened in the background, so you can also check by using this particular command. In all machines, now at this time we have defined here DevOps user, but it will automatically take the SSH by using the root. Now check, this will show me the root account because in background it performed the command. See, I will show you what will happen in the background. It will take the SSH by using the root account. See, I will show you this thing. What will happen for this command? So it will So this is my Ansible 2.8 version. This is the configuration file information. This is the my Python version. Now check, establish connection. Which particular user? I have defined my configuration file, which one? DevOps user. Now check. It will take the SSH by using the DevOps user, but switch the user for the root. Now check. So that is host key, DevOps user, all the things. SSH user DevOps for this particular machine. Echo establish connection. Okay, now it will change. Where is the information? It will perform the command. Authentication, pass preferred authentication, that is key based public key. Password authentication, no. User, this one, connection timeout. Where is the information to switch the user? DevOps user hyphen C. It have the information which one DevOps connection. It will all perform how many commands? More commands. So it's a just a combination of all script. Bin Python. I will show this. This one become success. Check the ID. Which command? Now you can see here. So it will take, that is this machine hyphen B become successfully. Now become user, then perform this particular command by using which particular user ID? This is the user ID. What is the RC code? That is a return code. This one start and this particular time delta, this ID warning use cell false. So it will perform a lot of option in the background, but we just, if I want to check all the things in verbose mode, so you can check this one, but if I type just this, only few things we can check. Lot of things will happen in the background by using which particular module? This particular module. It means, what is the meaning of this one? If I just type become false, it means it will not use the sudo. It will not use the sudo. If I just type here true, then what will happen? I will show one more thing. This is the last for this Ansible. If I type here just false here, then what will happen? And if I type here just true, then what will happen? See the result. If I create a user again and the username is Chirag, Chirag, then it will ask for which particular password? Become password. It means for this password. So we have type here true. So just type password, but this will not perform. What is the reason? Tell me, Rahul. See the result. Because in background it not uses the, because it perform the command by which particular? It perform the command like this. Then what is the result? Permission denied. If I use here just sudo, then I am able to perform the command. See the result. Because in background the command, I will show one more thing. Not like this. I will show a small thing. What is the use of this command? Mkdir. And I want to create a directory. Directory name is toy. And I want to create a another directory. The directory name is this one. But use here sudo. Then what is the meaning of this one? Then just ll. See the result. This command is performed by DevOps user. But this command is performed by root account. I'm using this command locally. Then you can check the meaning of this one. This command, mkdir command, is performed by sudo. So in background, sudo will take the SSH. It means super user do. So it will, the command is performed by the root account, because in a my account, in my system, root is the super user. So this command will perform. So when I take, you can take the SSH, we can perform any command by using like this one. So if I use the command like this, we use here user add, then the command will perform. Just type here user add, the command will perform. If I am not using like this, then command will not perform. If I like this one, then we are not able to perform this command, because this user is a standard user, then this cannot perform this particular command. So what is the reason of this one? See, because this is a administrative command, super binary file. So for using this particular super binary file, we should have the super user. Only super user can use this particular command. Okay. Now you have understand this. What will happen in the background? If I use here just false, so it will not use which command? Sudo command in the background. So we should have to write this particular thing true always. If any administrative command we want to perform, so we should have the become user sudo. So the command will perform as a sudo in front of any command. And if I want to type the become password, then just type true. If I do not want the password, then just type false. So we always type just false, because we don't password again and again. So this is the whole concept that will perform. So now change this thing again. This, then just remove this and true. You can use in a capital T, you can also use in a small T. There's no, just type here false. So now this Ansible has been completed. So see, inventory means specify the inventory location, remote user, this is a remote user information, ask pass, you can also pass. If you have SSH public key, you should have to write false. Become, so you can perform this particular command where automatically move to which particular user? Root. So it will use sudo command in a default manner. If you want to use sudo su, you can also use this option. So you can also use su also. Then become user, that will become as a root user. Become ask password, that is by default false. So you can type all of these things. So this is the whole meaning of this particular connection. So default has been completed, this one completed, this also completed. I have completed all of these things. See here, I have completed this thing also. Just copy ID, then go to this particular machine, then add this particular key, then we are able to perform. If we want to send the my public key in lot of machines, then we can write the playbook also. But at this time, I have no knowledge of the playbook. So we have not completed the playbook chapter. When we complete the playbook, then I will perform this later. Because my playbook chapter not started at this time. So I will not tell you this one. So this called privilege escalation, this has been completed. So this, I have told you this one also. So if I place no passwd in sudoers.d file, we can also create the file, individual file also by using that particular username, then provide the permission. So this whole thing has been completed and this also completed. Now, if we want to check the other connection, at this time I'm using SSH connection. If you have the Windows machine, then you can use WinRM connection. And what is the port number of WinRM? 5986. So this is the port number. Can also use this one. So this whole exercise has been completed. Now I will move to the last one, that is regarding to ad hoc command. I have also completed this particular command. So see, what is the meaning of ad hoc? Ad hoc is a command that we can perform. Suppose we want to create a user, individual user. So we don't need to write the whole playbook. We just use ad hoc command. So what is ad hoc command that I have used already? So this command is known as ad hoc command. So this is my ad hoc command. If I want to create a user on remote machine, see, I've created a lot of user here by using the ad hoc command. So I've created this, but Rahul Craw user, Geetu Craw user, Gaurav Craw users. I have created these three users. See, this is a way of executing a single Ansible task. If I want to perform a task, then we can use this particular command, ad hoc command. So once you do not need to save to run again, if we want to perform a command on a one time, so we don't need to create a whole script. Whole script means the playbook. So they are simple online operations that can be run without writing a playbook. So we don't need to write the playbook again and again. If we want to perform a task only one time, so we can use ad hoc command. Ad hoc is useful for quickly test and changes. For example, if I want to do a task, if we want to update the host file information, then just that is only one time. So we can use ad hoc command. So what is the syntax of ad hoc? So that is Ansible. This is the command, ad hoc command. Then host pattern. Host pattern means in which particular machine you want to perform this particular task. So this is my host pattern. That is all. And M is module. So you should have the module information. So this is my username module. And we want to perform some arguments. So after the module, you have placed the arguments. Argument means which particular task you want to perform. So just A for argument, this is my task that I want to perform on these all machines. So I will take the all parameter, all host group. So Ansible, then this is the syntax, host pattern, M for module, A for argument, and I for inventory. Inventory means which inventory that you want to use. So I have this place in my Ansible configuration file, so it will automatically take the inventory information. So this one, so we don't need to type this again and again. So C here, A for argument, M for module, I have completed. See this one. So this is my ad hoc command that is called Ansible command. All machines, check the SSH information. So that is ping pong. Ping pong is just check the SSH information. You are able to take the SSH or not. If you want to do a lot of information, if you want to take the lot of information about the module, suppose ad hoc Ansible hyphen documentation hyphen l, we want to check all the module information. So these are all the modules that can be performed by the Ansible. So these are all the module information. So I want to check about the ping module. So what is ping module? So I want to check just ping. Grab here ping. So what is ping module? So this is my ping module. So ping module is used to try to connect to host and verifying this one. And I want to check the information regarding the ping module. Just type the ping. So what is ping module? It's a trivial test module. This module always return pong, ping pong on successfully. If I am able to take the SSH, the information will present like this. It does not make sense in playbook, but it is useful for USR bin Ansible. So when we perform this particular command, this will be performed by using the Ansible. Verify the ability to log in. I am able to log in on the remote machine or not. And it uses the Python in the background. This is not just like the ICMP. So I have asked you which particular protocol use in ping, ICMP. But in this, we uses this particular tool, and all the command will be performed by the Python. So it will just take the SSH. So this is just trivial test module that require Python on the remote node. So it will perform that particular command by using the command module, and command module uses the Python in the background. For Windows targets, we should have this particular command win-ping to take the SSH, net SSH for the network target. So see, this is the whole thing about this one. So just suppose if I want to take the information about the user module, what is the user module? Then see, if I want to create a user on the remote machine, then we can manage user accounts and user attributes. For Windows target also, we can use win user command. If I want to create a user in my Windows machine, we can also use win underscore user. This module is maintained by the Ansible core team. Option that is append if I want to create. So we have lot of options: authorize, comment, expire, group, hidden, home, local, lot of options we have. We use only just this one. Just we have type the name and profile, remove, role. So we have lot of options. Cell, if we want to define bit, comment, lot of options. I have used only this one. See, so we have lot of example. In the last, there are some examples. See here, if I want to create a user, just type user here, just name here, name, comment, this is the comment, this is the user ID, this is a group of part, this one. So we have lot of information regarding this particular. So if you want to use this whole, you can take the example from this particular. So it's have its own documentation regarding any module. So see, this is all about the ping module. If you want to take the information regarding this particular module, you can go this particular Ansible doc documentation. You can also use online. Then ping pong, this information. If you want to do more about this particular module, this one. So just use this. Just type. See, you can get the lot of information. So this is the online documentation of this particular command. So what is the meaning of this one? So this is called pong. String, that is pong. What is the meaning of this one? Ansible, Windows, ping pong. So you can get all the information regarding this one. So you see, this is the user guide. If you want to take the more information about this one, so goes to this particular documentation, you can check. community guide. This is regarding the community guide. So, and if you want to check the information regarding the what is the YML syntax, so this is the syntax of YML. So we can got lot of information that I will show you later. So see this one, author, all the concepts, some example also. So we have these modules. What are the modules? We have module category. So these are the name of the module that I will use. We have a different chapter in this. All the modules are used. So we have copy module, file module, line in file module, synchronize module, yum module, apt, dnf, jam, pipe, firewall d, reboot, service, user. We have lot of modules. This is regarding the file module, this is regarding the software package module, this is regarding the system module. If I want to restart my machine, if I want to enable the firewall d information, we can also enable this. So I will show these all command one by one in the later session. So these are regarding the net. It means get URL information, NMCLI information, URI information. So see, I have told you Ansible, this is the ad hoc command. I want to create a user, use this particular module. A for argument, just give the name of that particular user. If you want to specify the user ID for that one, you can also specify the user ID of that user. Just state here and give the name of your machine that you want to. Suppose if I want like this, just type Ansible, this is my machine, all on the machine, hyphen a module, user module, use this particular hyphen a argument, just type name. So name of that particular user is anything. Suppose I want to create a user like this name. It's a Suhana. This is my username. So this is my username. If you want to specify the user ID, suppose we want to specify the UID information, just type the UID information, that is 3000. And if you want to provide the GID information, you can also provide the status, that is to be, if I want to provide the group information, so that is a part of that particular specific group, you can also provide the group information. See, and the status is present, that one. Then just type this. So these three users has been created on which machine? In this machine also. But and in this user we don't have the ID that is free on this machine, so it has the return code 400. So first you should have to check we have the free user ID or not. But in these two machines we have the free ID, then the user has been created. So first you should have to check the ID is free or not. If there is an error regarding this, it will show you the message. So now my user has been created. If I perform this particular command again, then for this it will show me error. For this, because it will not perform, change, append, it's a false. It means this will not perform because the user is already created. See here, this user is already created. So it will not perform this particular command again. But for this, it will show me an error. So see this particular thing. Most of the module that have this particular idempotent function, it means what is the meaning of idempotent? If we run a command that can be a ad hoc command, if we run the playbook by using any module, so we can perform any command multiple times safely on multiple machines. So idempotent means they can be run safely multiple times and the system is already in the correct status. It means correct status means if we have already created that particular user, then the command will not perform. They do nothing. For if you run the ad hoc command again, it will report, see here false status. Now check here, when we perform this command on the first time, the changes occur. It means true, create this particular user. But now see this one, same option, change status false. There is no change occur. That is great. When we type, if we have this particular type of color, it means the task will be performed. So every particular module have this particular functionality that is called idempotency. Idempotency means we can perform a command, we can perform a playbook multiple time on any host machine, and if we are in a correct status, then the task will not perform again and again. So we can run multiple command, ad hoc command, playbook multiple times on a same host.
Sir, it means it like append the command.
Append it just not. Suppose if I am here, if I check, we have a user, we have check in etc passwd file, we have a user one. Yes, I check, we have a user this one. So I will not perform this particular command. So it will goes to that particular manage host machine and check this particular user is created or not. If this user is already created, then this particular user add command will not perform. So what is the meaning of this one? It will not perform the command again and again, because this particular module have the functionality of idempotency. It will check first in that particular account, in that particular machine, we have this type of user or not. It will check first, then perform this particular user add command in the background. If that user is already created, then it means already created means in a correct status, then it will do nothing. It means user add command will not perform, will not take effect any.
Okay.
So this is the meaning of this one. So now check, this also has been completed. If you want to use the command module, you can also use if you want to check the host name of all machine. So see, if I want to check the host name of all machine, so we use command module hyphen a argument, and we want to check the host name of all machine. Now check, this is the host name of manage host machine, and this is the host name of 120 machine. This is the host name of this particular machine, and we can also write the whole command, because this particular command will perform from which location? USR bin. You can like type like this one slash bin, and from bin perform this particular command same way. And we can also type here slash USR, because this command also present in USR location. Same. And see here, we have the result in two lines. Suppose if we want to place this particular result only one line, you can use this particular O option. So hold the result will be presented in one line. So see the result up from this particular command. So this is all about the ad hoc command. We can also have the other command. See the meaning of this one. This particular command, we have a command and we want to perform the module, and we want to perform a command, that is set command. So now check, we have the error, but now check, we have performed, because this is a set is a Linux command that uses the bash program. So this particular command can be interpreted by using which particular program? That uses bash program. But I have told you, when we perform this particular module, it uses the Python script. So this not understand this particular command, because this is a bash program command. So see the result here. So it will failed issue because this command will not work. If I use here just cell, so it will automatically uses the bash program, your bash program. So we can also use here which particular module? This particular shell module. So this particular command will perform and the result will appear in front of you. So see the difference. See from this. For situation where command module requires shell processing, administrators can use this particular shell module. Like command module, you pass the command to be executed argument to the command module ad hoc command. So Ansible then execute the command remotely on the manage host. Unlike the command module, the commands are processed through the shell module. When we use which particular command module, the command is processed through a shell on the manage host. Therefore, shell environment variable are accessible. The shell operations such as redirection pipeline always available. So see the difference between shell module and particular this module. And we can also have the other module. Suppose we have a environment where there is no Python background, then we can also use raw module. See this one, we can also perform this particular command. But one more thing you can, if you want to check, suppose we have a command module and we want to perform a command uptime. See, we are able to perform. If we use this like raw module, we can. So we have different modules to perform the Linux command also presented. Suppose if I want to use one more command, so that is that I want to perform ls cpu information by using this command also present. Both command will, suppose if I use your command module, see the result, it will show me error because if I want to perform more than one command at a time as an argument, so this will not recognize. So command module have some limitations, but if I want to use raw module in the place of command, the command will perform because it not uses the Python in the background, not require the pass. Suppose we have a router and in a router we want to do some configuration, then we can't use command module, we can use raw module. So we have different modules and some modules have some limitations, but this command module, shell module and raw module not have the functionality of idempotency. This not have the functionality of idempotency. What is the meaning of idempotency? I will show you again. If I perform user add command and create jet123 user in all the machine, user is created. Now again type, this will show me an error. But if I use the user module, this will not show me an error because the command will be performed again and again and then show me the user is already exist. So this message cannot be, this message will show you this command run again and again. If I use here user module, the command will not run. If the user already exists, the command will not work. So that is the meaning of idempotency. So see operation redirection. See both command module and shell module, both are uses which particular Python installation will require on which machine? Manage host machine. While this is my raw module, can run command directly using the remote shell. It not uses the Python in the background. Bypass the module. Some systems this useful when managing systems that are not have the Python run in the background, run in the on the that particular device or that particular router. So it can be used in, it can be used to install the Python on the host. So see here, most circumstances it is not recommended to practice that you avoid the command module, shell module and raw module, because these have not the functionality of idempotency. So most other modules are idempotent, can perform change tracking automatically. They test the status of your system and they do nothing if those systems are already in the correct status. By contrast, it is much more complicated to use run command module in the way that to be idempotent. So see the result, same result, because this has no functionality to be idempotent. Only one time it will run again and again. If I use a module that is have the functionality of idempotency, then that particular command will not perform in the background. So see, depending upon them, make it is harder to use confident that use failure. Playbook not causes the unexpected failure. So see this, it's a failure. Error. When shell and command module run, typically report change status band based on whether it think it affect machine status. So when you use this particular module, so do not need to use them. So this is the concept. So we have also completed hyphen I option, hyphen U option, hyphen B means become option, hyphen happen. So we have command line utility also, and we have the configuration utility also. In configuration file, we write like this. In a command line, we use like this. Hyphen hyphen become user ask. So we can use, if you want to take the help, you can also take the help. So this is the whole concept. This is the Ansible command. In this, we have completed this command also ID command also, DevOps, this whole command also. See the meaning of this particular command. This is a copy module, and I want to see, this is my ad hoc command. This is my local machine. It means if I want to perform any particular task in my local machine also, we can also perform local machine. Hypermem, it means module, use this particular copy module and write some content on which particular file. So create a file. So destination is etc. In this etc, create a file motd. By using which particular account? This account. If I want to remove this one, we can also remove because we have already set in my configuration file. So see here, this is the last command. See, cat /etc/motd. We have no file and we have no content in this particular file. And I want to put some content in this particular file. So we can use copy module to copy the content and for other work also. So this will happen in my local machine. See, but I want to perform this in remote machine. Then what I will do? I will use just all parameter, all host group in place of localhost. So it will take, so check. Now check. I am able to write something in this particular file. So this will copy. So we can use this one. If you want to not writable, okay, so use this. See here, there is no become option here, so this message show not writable. But see, hyphen hyphen become means, so you should have the permission to write anything in this particular etc location. So now perform by the root, and in this all, if you perform this motd user become, so this is for the localhost machine and this is for the all machine that I have already told you. And if you want to check, so you can check this by using this particular command. So check this one. This is my ad hoc command, all a module, a argument you want to check that app. So just copy this one and run this command here. So you can check in this machine also write, in this machine also write, in this machine also write. So we have write the content on which particular command? Abotd command. What is the permission of that? ls-l. So we can use root has been created this particular file. Who created this particular? Who write the content on this particular file? Only root. See, so this exercise completed. So now in the next session I will start the third chapter, that is regarding the implementing playbooks. So this is the next topic that I will start. So I will end the session. If any doubt regarding this, you can ask any question.